Who of you has published a journal article? Yes, very good. And did you get credits from your university? Did it count in your research evaluation? Show of hands. Yes, very good. Who of you published a book? I see a couple of books, people. Excellent. And did it count in your research evaluation? Ooh, one, two. Not too bad, not too bad. Still no slides, though. This is really the point where I really should have slides now. Yeah? Oh, that's funny. Yeah? I can use my my laptop.
Is it the mouse presentation with the video?
No. Yeah. Here we are. Now I lost my remote, but that's fine. Okay, so this I already done. And then yesterday I was actually analyzing the buzz on Twitter around this conference. And I wanted to find out whether there were any talks or whether there were any discussions around books. And as you can see, it's fairly disappointing. There's a lot about open science, about Berlin, careers, early career, researcher. And I did an occasional tweet about book metrics, but there's not really a huge buzz about books. And actually, as an author, as I already mentioned, it's not so good. Why do you want to write a book if you actually have hardly any idea what the impact of your book is and whether it counts in your research evaluation? As a publishing editor, you also would like to get more books in, sign more books, but then it really helps if you have reliable metrics. So that's where we come in, because I think if we move on like this, actually books might be extinct in a couple of years. So we built Bookmetrics, and Bookmetrics pulls together all the information around attention paid to and the use of and the impact of books. And we found out that books actually benefit hugely around new ways of attention and impact. And books like journals, and if I get this now in a pointer, maybe not, okay, yes. So here's an example of one of those books. Here you see a book published in 1991. And for whatever reason, probably a blog post or a tweet or anything, we suddenly see here a huge jump of social media activity around this book, actually, starting January 2015, which is quite a couple of years after the book was actually published. And if we look at the archival content, so books published before the year 2000, we found 42,000 books mentioning a total of 89,000 books. So actually, the story behind the book doesn't stop when the book is actually published. And Bookmetrics is for free. So you might be curious now what it is. Well, here we are. We have our platform, an API, and we get information from Mendeley, from Crossref, from two Springer APIs, from the Omics feed, and from Altmetrics. And we bring all of that together on a chapter level, And we post the information on both Springer.com and SpringerLink in these little boxes, which I'll show you in a minute. And so within these boxes, you can find, if available, information around chapters, around citations, around mentions, readers, reviews, and downloads in from the different sources. And you can actually click on each one of these and go to the dedicated detail page. So in this case, I went to one of our one of the open access books that that are out there, Opening Science. And you can see here the summary of all the activity for this particular book. But you can also see on you know, if you're a chapter author, you can also see the information for your chapter and see that you have so many downloads or mentioned and so on. Zooming in on the other side, if you go to the mentions in this case, you can see the altmetric donut, but then without a score. You see how many mentions there are of each source, and you can see the build-up of your of the online activity around your book or chapter. And you can dive in, actually. You can click on see more mentions, and you can see here who has been mentioning, like, for example, Martin Finn. And I know Martin, and I know that he wrote this particular chapter, so he must be promoting his own work, which is really good. Mendeley, we also have the information from Mendeley. You can see some readership statistics, the professional status, the discipline, and so on. Now, how have we been doing since the launch in April? Quite good, I would say. We're very happy. The number of visitors between August and October increased by 25%. Returning visitors also increased. Page views increased by 40%, and this is all traffic on bookmetrics.com itself. We have a lot of tweets from people, and we were also nominated, though we didn't win, sadly, for the ALPSP Innovation Award. Now, there's of course also citation information in there, and the trouble with the traditional databases like Web of Science and Scopus is that they focus primarily on journals in their platform, but also in their research evaluation. So I looked up the information around Springer books, and Springer, in Bookmetrics, we currently have over 200,000 books in our database, and also citations for all of these books. If you look up the Springer books in Scopus, we have 20,000, so 1/10. Which means that to 180,000 authors, I have to say, sorry, your book may have been cited, however, Scopus doesn't index. Web of Science is even worse, they have 10,000 of our books indexed. We are using Crossref, and we found out that actually books are really, really highly cited. And they have high value for librarians. So you see, we have on average for all of these 200,000 books, we have 20 citations per book, which is probably which may actually be more than for an average journal, depending which one, of course. But anyway, and the cited half-life for books is roughly somewhere between the 20 and 30 years. Now, there's one teeny tiny problem with books that we have, as publishers, have been also a little bit sloppy with. Let's put it this way, we're amongst friends here, so I can be honest. Which is that actually, here we find a reference in an article, and there's actually no link here. Which means that this reference is not registered in Crossref. And this book, of the author of this book, Henk Moot, doesn't know that his book is cited in this particular article using Crossref. So if there's no outbound link with Crossref in the reference list, there's no additional citations for this book. Now, my question to you, how many references to books in chapters and articles on SpringerLink do not have a link out to Crossref? Wrong one. Books, who cites books, might be an option. 30 to 40%, 50, 60, 70, 80, or same as articles. Of course, everybody cites book, and there should be a link. We just found the odd one. Let's have a vote very quickly in 1 minute. Books, the first one. 30 to 40%, 50 to 60%, or 70 to 80%. And last, authors, articles. There's one very optimistic person. Unfortunately, it's 30 to 40%. So 30 or 40% of the references in chapters and articles to books do not have a link out with Crossref. So what we have been busy with the last half years is developing a little algorithm together with a company called Crest, which you may want to invite next year as a startup. And we're going to clean up all our data. So we go through all the 10 million documents that we have on Springerlink, go through all the references, try to find the ones that do not have a link, and we fix that. And we've done a pilot already, and actually we can increase this percentage with 70%. And so then we, you know, I think that's one of the greatest auto service that we can provide, so that you know that your book is being cited in articles, we are happy to do that also for other publishers. Just come to me and we'll have a nice discussion. So that's all about books and book metrics. And I want to say on a final note, stop judging books by the cover. Just look up their metrics. They also have metrics. That's it.